हेलो चिल्ड्रेन, गुड मॉर्निंग. वेलकम टू ज्योग्राफी क्लास. टुडेज क्लास विल स्टडी फ्रॉम पेज नंबर 323 टू टुडे विल स्टार्ट अ न्यू चैप्टर, चैप्टर 21, सबमरीन रिलीफ. टुडे विल स्टडी फ्रॉम पेज नंबर 323 टू पेज नंबर 327. द ऑब्जेक्टिव दैट विल स्टडी इन दिस चैप्टर आर: नंबर वन, मेजर डिविजन्स ऑफ ओशन फ्लोर. नंबर टू, पैसिफिक ओशन, रिलीफ ऑफ द फ्लोर ऑफ द पैसिफिक ओशन. नंबर थ्री, एटलांटिक ओशन, द रिलीफ ऑफ द फ्लोर ऑफ द एटलांटिक ओशन. एंड नंबर फोर, Indian Ocean and the relief of the floor of the Indian Ocean. In today's class, we'll study two objectives. They are: number one, major divisions of ocean floor. Number two, Pacific Ocean, the relief of the ocean floor of the Pacific Ocean. The ocean surface has highs and lows similar to the hills and valleys of the earth's surface, called as ocean surface topography or dynamic topography, as they are ever changing. These are mapped using measurements of sea surface height relative to earth's surface. Ocean surface topography is caused by ocean waves, tides, currents, and loading of the atmospheric pressure. The main purpose to measure ocean surface topography is to understand the large scale circulation of the ocean. Now, let us go through the technical terms that are coming in today's topic. The first term here is submarine, existing or occurring under the surface of the sea, is called submarine. Relief, physical features or landforms like mountains, plains and plateaus. Hydrosphere, part of the earth which is covered by water. Ocean, large water bodies surrounding the land masses or continents of the globe. Example, the Pacific Ocean and the Indian Ocean. Trenches, long, narrow, steep-sided depressions on the ocean floor. Example, Mariana Trench. Tectonic, related to the structure of the earth crust. Continental shelf, slightly inclined or tilted. Inundated zone means flooded zone, which structurally form the border of the continent and the ocean. Continental slope, at the edge of the continental shelf, the slope becomes steep. This part of the ocean with steep slope is called continental slope. Continental rise, beyond the continental slope, there is a continental rise. It is an area of gentle slope with general relief of low structure and it merges with abyssal plain. Abyssal plain, the deep sea plain is called abyssal plain. Gorges, an undersea mountain with a flat top. Canyon, a large valley with very steep slope is called a canyon. Inundated, flooded. Marine, related to sea or found in the sea. Abyssal, related to the bed of the ocean floor where the depth is between 3000 meter to 6000 meter. Strait, a narrow stretch of water that separates two large land masses and joins two large water bodies, is called a strait. example Bering Strait and Park Strait. Marginal seas, division of the ocean partially enclosed by islands, archipelagos means group of islands and peninsulas. Example Sea of Japan and Arabian Sea. Now let us read the chapter from page 323. About 71% of the earth's surface is covered by water. This vast expanse of water area is called hydrosphere. Earth is the only planet in the whole solar system which contains such a large quantity of water. Thus, many scholars called Earth as watery planet. Sea is the general term used for any specific area of salt water, usually on the margins, that is borders of the continent. The great mass of salt water surrounding the land masses on the globe is known as ocean. The ocean floor is not plain as was generally believed earlier. Oceans are rugged, complex, with world's longest mountain ranges, deepest trenches and large plains. Four processes are responsible for the great variety of relief on the ocean floors. The relief of the ocean floor is largely due to the interaction of tectonic, volcanic, erosional and depositional process. The ocean floor can be divided into four major divisions. They are continental shelf, continental slope, continental rise and abyssal plain. Let us discuss about these four divisions in detail one by one with the help of some pictures and diagrams. Continental shelf is slightly inclined means tilted, inundated means flooded zone which structurally form the border of the continent. It is generally formed by drowning off a part of the continent with a relative rise in the sea level or marine deposition beneath the water. It has a gentle slope and its maximum depth is about 200 meters. Its width varies with its slope. The continental shelf of steep slope is narrow while that of gentle slope is quite broad. Its average width is about 70 kilometers. It is almost absent in the eastern Pacific Ocean, especially in South America. It covers about 7.5% of the total area of the world's ocean. Continental shelf is the most important part of the ocean floor. The sun rays can penetrate up to the depth of the continental shelves, which helps in the growth and reproduction of marine organism and vegetation. Therefore, the continental shelves are of great use to man. Most of the marine food is obtained from the continental shelves. They provide the richest fishing ground. They are also potential mining sites for economic minerals. About 20% of the world petroleum and gas comes from the continental shelves. They are also the large storehouse of sand and gravel. The second division of the ocean floor is the continental slope. Continental slope is found beyond the continental shelf. At the edge of the continental shelf, the seaward slope immediately becomes very steep. This part of the ocean floor with steep slope is called continental slope. It extends to a depth of about 3,660 meters. There are five types of continental slopes. Number one, fairly steep with surface dissected by canyons. Second, gentle slope with elongated hills and basins. Third, faulted or fractured slopes. Fourth, slopes with terraces or steps. And fifth, slopes with sea mountains. The next division of the ocean floor is the continental rise, which we can see here. Beyond the continental slope is the continental rise. It is an area of gentle slope. Its general relief is low. With increasing depth, the continental rise merges with the abyssal plain. The next division of the ocean floor is abyssal plain, where the continental rise ends. The deep sea plain known as abyssal plain begins. These are almost flat areas with very gentle slope or flat terrain. They are extensive areas covering about 40% of the ocean floor. Their depth varies from 3,000 to 6,000 meters. They are present in all major oceans and several seas in the world. Apart from these four divisions, the ocean floor has some other important features like submarine ridges, abyssal hills, submarine trenches, submarine canyons. Let us know about them with the help of some diagrams and pictures. Here we can see in the center of the diagram there is Mid-Atlantic Ridge. Mid-Atlantic Ridge is the longest ocean ridge in the world. Now, what is a ridge? These are underwater mountain which are a few hundred kilometers wide and several thousand kilometers long. They are ridges of high relief, that is, they are the chain of mountains and form the longest mountain system on the earth. Most of the ridges are placed centrally in the oceans. The best example here is the Mid-Atlantic Ridge. The total length of submarine ridge system is over 75,000 kilometers. The next feature is the abyssal hills. Abyssal hills are thousands of hills which are present on the ocean floor. A submarine mountain or peak rising more than 1000 meters above the ocean floor is known as sea mount or sea mountain. Flat topped sea mountains are known as geoids. All these features are volcanic in origin. Pacific Ocean has the largest number of geoids and seamounts. It is estimated that there are nearly 10,000 abyssal hills in the Pacific Ocean. The next feature here is trenches, submarine trenches. A trench is a long narrow and steep-sided depression on the ocean floor. Trenches are the deepest part of the ocean bottom, with their usual depth of about 5,500 meters. Trenches have been formed due to downfaulting or downfolding of the earth crust. Therefore, they are tectonic in origin. It means that they are formed due to volcanic activity or earthquake activity. They are most common in the Pacific Ocean. The deepest trench in the world is the Mariana Trench in the Pacific Ocean. And the deepest point of the ocean in the world is Challenger Deep, which is 11,035 meters below the sea level. Mariana Trench is over 11 kilometers in depth. If Mount Everest were to be submerged in this trench, then its peak would still remain 2 kilometers below the sea level. Trenches are most common in the Pacific Ocean. So far, 57 trenches have been located, out of which 32 are in the Pacific Ocean, 19 in the Atlantic Ocean, and the remaining 6 is in the Indian Ocean. Trenches form an almost continuous ring along the eastern and the western margin of the Pacific Ocean. The last feature of the ocean floor is the submarine canyons. A submarine canyon is a steep-sided depression on the sea floor crossing the continental shelf slope and sometimes even the continental rise. They are formed by the erosive activity of the ocean water. They are sometimes small in size, sometimes they become deeper in size when the mouth of a river extends up to the continental shelf. We can find canyons. For example, we can see many such canyons formed by River Zaire, Mississippi, and even River Indus. Our next topic to study is oceans. In all, there are 5 oceans on the earth. They are Pacific Ocean, Atlantic Ocean, the Indian Ocean, Arctic Ocean, and the Antarctic Ocean. The first 3 oceans are more important, and the relief of their floor is to be discussed briefly in this chapter. See all these 5 oceans in this world map: Pacific Ocean, Atlantic Ocean, Indian Ocean, Arctic Ocean, and the Southern Ocean. Now, let us study about the Pacific Ocean in detail. Size and shape. The Pacific Ocean is the largest ocean in the world. It has an area of 165,723,740 square kilometer, which is about 1/3 of the total surface area of the earth. Thus, this vast ocean has an area which exceeds the total area of the world. It stretches to over 16,000 kilometers along the equator. It is 14,880 kilometers from Bering Strait in the north to Cape Adare in Antarctic continent in the south. It is roughly triangular in shape. It is bounded by Asia and Australia in the west, and a chain of immediate islands on the east by north South America, on the south by Antarctica. Let us study the floor of Pacific Ocean. Pacific Ocean is the deepest of all oceans. Continental shelf is not much developed in this ocean. Only 7% of the ocean is less than 1000 meter deep. The major portion of the ocean basin has an average depth of about 7300 meter. The Northern Pacific Ocean is deepest part of the ocean. Here the Pacific Ocean has an average depth of 5000 to 6000 meter. There are several trenches in the Pacific Ocean. The important trenches in the Pacific Ocean are the Aleutian Trench, the Kuril Trench, the Japan Trench, etc. The Mariana Trench in the Pacific Ocean is the deepest trench in the world. It has a depth of 11,033 meter. There are several sea mounts, gyots and islands in the central part of this ocean. The Hawaii Ridge is well known. Now let us see the islands of Pacific Ocean in this map. The important islands in the North Pacific Ocean are the Aleutian Islands, the Kuril Island, Japan, Philippines, the other islands in the Central and South Pacific Ocean are the Hawaii Island near USA, the Indonesian Island, New Zealand and the British Columbia. Now let us see the marginal seas of the Pacific Ocean. Marginal seas are the seas along the continent. The important marginal seas of Pacific Ocean are the Bering Strait, the Sea of Okhotsk, the Sea of Japan, East China Sea, South China Sea, Solomon Sea, Coral Sea, the Cook Strait in North America, it is the Gulf of Alaska. Here, the Gulf of California, the eastern coast of Pacific Ocean has very limited marginal seas. With this, we complete our today's topic. Your homework is to go through exercise number 1, question number 1, how much percentage of the earth is covered with water? Question number 2, name the deepest place in the ocean. Question number 3, how much part of the earth's surface is covered by the Pacific Ocean? Question number 4, what percentage of the ocean floor is covered by the continental shelf? Question number 6, name the most common features found on the ocean floors. Question number 7, why is the earth known as watery planet? Question number 8, give one term for the following statement: 1, 2, 2 and 3, all three parts. Exercise number 2nd, question number 1. Explain continental shelf, what are its uses? Question number 2nd, what are the main characteristics of submarine canyons? Name the best known canyon in the world. Question number 4, distinguish between number 1, continental shelf and continental slope, number 2, seamount and gullet, number 3, submarine trench and submarine canyon. Exercise number 3, question number 1, discuss in detail the various features found on the ocean floor. Question number 3, give an account of the Pacific Ocean. Question number 5, discuss the major submarine features, giving specific example. On the outline map of the world, show the marginal seas and islands of Pacific Ocean. Show Mariana Trench and the Sunda Trench. Children, you have to write the answers of the following questions on copy. Number 1, define hydrosphere and ocean. Number 2, name the 4 divisions of the ocean floor. Explain each with the help of a diagram. Number 3, explain submarine ridge, abyssal hills, submarine trenches, submarine canyons. Question number 4, describe the relief of the ocean floor of the Pacific Ocean. Children, hope that you have understood the chapter. Please read the topic properly from your book. See the given school link and the YouTube link. Thank you very much.